one of the many things that was important to me was that I was born and raised in a very tough Brooklyn neighborhood. And because I started camp when I was 5 and went for many years. And one of the things that was so important to me, maybe particularly, was that because so many of the campers, and especially my bunkmates, were also from New York, we continued to see each other throughout the year, not just at camp.
That's right.
So that was especially important to me, because I never would have had friends like that in my community.
I think a lot of us experienced that.
I think you had your hand up, Mike. Somebody else before?
Oh, I'm sorry, Ron.
This is kind of a little story. I'm not sure how it fits in with what other people have been saying, but it's something that's always stuck with me. Our bunk in, I can't remember whether it's 59 or 60, probably 59, Carl and I were in the same bunk. It was a good bunk, a bunch of good guys, and there was one particularly sweet kid who, his name was Hop, and the camp was more diverse politically than some of us might have thought. And it was wonderful to be at camp where your views were in the majority, but it didn't necessarily mean that everybody agreed with you. But we thought everybody did. at least that's the way we felt. And I guess we discussed things that were important. I remember getting into a discussion about atheism, which we were, of course, all atheists, right? And I guess, you know, particularly in this bunk, I guess Carl and I together could be pretty intellectually intimidating.
Speak for yourself.
This kid Hop, this quiet, sweet kid, said, "But my father's a minister." and we were talking about how, you know, God was there to oppress the people, religion was bad, and all this kind of stuff. And he said, but my father's a minister, and he's just trying to do good. And what was interesting to me, and it stuck with me to this day, was we kind of fell all over ourselves, not attacking him, but saying, well, just because a lot of religion is bad doesn't mean all religion is bad. It doesn't mean all ministers are bad. And your father could be a really good person and still be a minister. And I think, you know, Hop in this situation probably learned that there were atheists. And we learned that we could have really good friends who were really good people whose fathers were ministers. So it cut both ways.
Yeah. But the piece.
Someone asked me, what's a typical day at camp? What goes on? And then I said, we get up and we raise the flag and we pledge allegiance. And since then, I've been thinking how remarkable that was. I think part of the spirit of camp was that was not that we opposed our country, but that we were aware of what was positive about it, of the beacon of freedom of Jefferson and Lincoln, which is not to deny a little skepticism, when we said, with liberty and justice for all, the idealists said, with liberty and justice for all someday, and the materialists said, with liberty and breakfast for all. But we were sincere about it. Camp Woodland was where I memorized the First Amendment to the Constitution, because not only did we say it, we learned to sing it.
Yes.
The establishment of religion, prohibiting
the free exercise thereof, or abridging
the freedom of speech,
or of the press,
or the right
of the people peaceably to assemble.
Thank you.